14.777. Up next to qualify, a former Habitat. All these beautiful women in Cleveland, Tennessee tonight, folks. We've got to have them. We've got to go racing. Two series provisionals at the end will be coming to green for the start of the first concy. Chief starter Monty Morrow with the green flag furled up, ready to go. It'll be Riley Hickman, Todd Morrow, pair of ones, pair of twos, a row two. Here we go, down the main straightaway. Green flag is out racing down the main straightaway into quarter number one.
And out the top side, the catbird seat here at the Cleveland Speedway. Todd Morrow leads out of turn three and four. Here comes Riley back to the bottom.
Oh, man, big hill contact with Ryan Booth, third, fourth, and the point. Here comes Riley Hickman off turn two. Down the back straightaway to the inside of Todd Morrow.
Riley Hickman looking back to the inside of the number one. Todd Morrow leads lap number two on the CarSmart Auto Sales scoreboard. In turn three, Riley Hickman back to the inside.
Hickman down the back straightaway, pulling out by about a half a car length. Riley Hickman to the lead, slides to the inside now, will lead lap number four down the back straightaway.
Lap three actually in the books. It is Riley Hickman, Todd Morrow, Ty Dillon right there on the spoiler of Todd Morrow for third.
Ty Dillon in car number two, his first ever trip in a super late model here tonight. Driving for Richard Childress Racing here this weekend. Ty Dillon, a young 18-year-old driver out of Louisville, North Carolina. Watching slide back there for the third spot, Big Hill Ford. Brian Booth does not need to use a provisional. Needs to try to get into the show tonight. Five down, five to go.
Brian Booth outside looking in. He's trying to get by Big Hill for that fourth place spot. Riley Hickman showing the way. Your 11th quick qualifier here tonight. He'll come down for lap number six. Inside, halfway home, four to go. Riley Hickman is your leader. The American Billet, Rick Hickson Fabrication R1 race car is out in front.
Here comes Big Hill to the inside. We want position number three. Ty Dillon gets squirrely. Here comes Victor Thrill down the main straightaway. Brian Metal Jr. slows into turn number three. Caution flag waves. Our first caution, and Big Hill was going to the inside of Ty Dillon. But with seven laps complete, Riley Hickman still leads. As you see the white 16 of Brian Nettle Jr. out of Claxton, Georgia, slowing down the main straightaway. He'll bring out our first caution here in B Main number one.
On the road, I need you on the hill, gentlemen. Let's go. 16 car, he'll pull into the pit area, so he's done. Here on lap number seven, CarSmart Auto Sales scoreboard in turn three, ready to ride, just like it says. $500 down, you ride. One of our big sponsors here at the Cleveland Speedway. Riley Hickman leads it. Todd Morrow followed by Ty Dillon and Vic the Thrill Hill.
Ready to go, Riley Hickman showing it wide. And here comes Ty Dillon. He pushes just a bit, can't complete the pass on Todd Morrow. But Ty Dillon down to the bottom side. Watch that Arca driver go. Side by side, can't make it stick back into position. 3-2 to go.
Ty Dillon will fall in line right behind Todd Morrow. Again, he peeks to the inside. Can't make it stick off of turn number two.
Coming down to the white flag, Chief Starter Monty Morrow with the white flag in hand. One more lap to go for Riley Hickman and then turn number one.
Side by side, Ty Dillon on the inside of Todd Morrow. Riley Hickman smooth sailing into three and four. Ty Dillon takes over second from Morrow.
And what about it down the back straightaway? Who's it going to be? Third spot over the fourth spot of Todd Morrow. So Todd Morrow, starting the outside front row, he went to fourth. Your winner in the R1 car out of Soddy Daisy, Tennessee, in car in the first concy, Ottawa, Tennessee, right around Soddy Daisy down there. Your winner in car number R1, Riley Hickman.
You'll have to pardon his map questing abilities.
I learned them from you.
Anyway, Riley Hickman out of Ottawa, Tennessee.
Concy number two, Tommy Kerr, Randy Weaver, Jamie Oliver, Cindy Kingcock, Jeff Smith in the Dallas, North Carolina, the son of Hall of Famer Freddie Smith in the 18. Not the Jeff Smith from Atlanta, Georgia, but the 18 of North Carolina, Jeff Smith. So Rocket Boy and the Dream Weaver on the front row, two pair of East Tennessee regulars. Set to bring them down slowly out of turn number four. Kerr and Weaver, here we go. Green is out.
Once again, the Catbird seat working nicely here, but here comes Rocket Boy back to the bottom, down the backside. The yellow flag is out.
B-mains or any racing action for that matter. Steve Hickson, what a start that was. Tommy Kerr, Randy Weaver, they get another shot at it. Who's going to be up top? Here we go. Chief starter Monty Morrow says we'll get one more shot at it, folks. After we get the debris off, we'll see what happens. One more consi yet to go. You need to be in staging. One more consi, and then two pro late model crate divisional heat races. So crate pros, whatever you like to call them. They call them pro late models in Kentucky. It sounds much better than crate late models.
All right, here we go. Keep your eyes in turn three and four. Rocket Boy Tommy Kerr on the point, and Randy the Dream Weaver in the 116. Negatory, negatory on the flurry right there.
You got to diagnose that one as a little bit of premature acceleration there, Steve.
Right, what my little buddy Perry calls happy feet. So we'll line them back up, Monty transfer. Consi number three, consi number three, ready to go. Consi number three, be ready to go. All right, here we go. Rocket Boy Tommy Kerr and Randy the Dream Weaver in turn three and four.
Good start. Looking at the green now, making pretty low. Randy Weaver, Kerr's not going to let him have it. Kerr wants to be inside the lead position. Weaver back up top, good side to side, battle down the main straightaway. Who's going to lead?
Randy the Dream Weaver by a half a nose, but here comes Rocket Boy. Battle for position, that final transfer spot. Here comes Kenzer. And Randy the Dream Weaver is your leader, the 116 BKW Disaster Relief Bailey Company sponsored car out in front. Rocket Boy Tommy Kerr followed by Jeff Smith, and then the other number 18, that is Brandon Kenzer out of Allen, Kentucky. Oh, in turn one,
Oliver goes around in turn number one. First caution flag coming out. Started here, and we were set ready to work the fifth lap, I believe. Steve, we'll have to look at it, see if they back it up, and we'll see what they do right here. Looks up right for him, spinning it in turn number one.
All by his lonesome, too. It looked like the car just broke the number 18 of Jeff Smith, then the number 18 of Brandon Kenzer. The top four transfer, that means Brian Reese is outside looking in the number 33. So is Jeff Newbert, and so is the number 12, Tony Shrumpshire. Jeff Newbert trying to take away that fifth place spot. They get hung together in turn two. Randy Weaver still leading as we are inside five to go this time by. Weaver with about a three-car length advantage over Tommy Kerr down the back straightaway. Looking at lap number seven this time by. Coming out this time by for Randy the Dream Weaver. Weaver pulling some about six car lengths now over your second place car. Here comes the Dream. Randy Weaver to the checkered flag for consi number two. Tommy Kerr takes second, followed by Jeff Smith and Brandon Kenzer. Those cars will transfer. On the outside looking in, Jeff Newbert in the number 86. He'll finish fifth. followed by the number 12 car of Tony Shrimpshire. That's going to do it for consolation race number two. See number three, the final one coming up. Heat races for the limited crates. Get ready, drivers.
On the pole of Consi number three, the three out of Council Bluffs, Iowa, to be the Joker, Mike Collins. Alongside him in car number eight, the driver out of Murphy, North Carolina, Coach David Putt.
All right, here we go, race fans. Mike Collins, the Joker out of Council Bluffs, Iowa. Alongside of him, the coach, David Payne. Here they come. Keep your eyes in. Three and four this time by green flag. David Payne doing a little Indian giving. He'll take the lead down the back straightaway. Back straight away, wheel to wheel, door to door. Rick Rogers on the outside. Brad Shear making his debut on the inside. Brad Shear takes the spot. Here comes Rick Rogers back to the inside. Battle for fifth back there. Kerry Jones on the outside looking in. The yellow flag, he'll do the dual 180s in turn number one. And Ronnie Payne brings it into the pit area as his son David DeGreen, as everybody catches back up to the lead pack. Dave, that is Donald Brad Shear Jr. and Rick Rogers in the 44. Kerry Jones in that number six. He's outside looking in, the top four transfer, three laps on the Car Smart Auto Sales scoreboard. Here we go. Here we go. David Payne in the number eight car, bringing him back down to green. David Payne picking him up and putting him down as Brian Smith doesn't come into power. Yellow flag is out. Brian Smith did not come up to power. So yellow flag coming back out. So that'll negate the restart. Official t-shirt. I don't know what the heck they saw. Somebody saw something.
Chief starter Monty Marlow had the yellow light. I'll try it again. Hopefully they'll be racing this time by. Here we go, restart last five.
And this time John Henderson gets a shot. He's going to take a look to the inside of Rick Rogers. John Henderson taking a peek for that final transfer spot. He's got it. Oh, my goodness. Henderson coming from sixth. He'll take over fourth. Inside five, this time by. Coach David Payne in his own zip code right now as he has got a half a straightaway lead over the number three car of Mike Collins.
Tough race, Rick Rogers, slows down the main straightaway, coming up on two to go, David Payne, Mike Collins, Donald Brasher, Tom Anderson, Harry Rogers.
White flag coming out this time by for the coach, David Payne, as Rick Rogers limps off.
Right to the 44, the big KW Disaster Warriors.
Number three, white flag is out this time by for the coach, David Payne. Kerry Jones has got to go now. He is trying to chase down John Henderson for that final spot. The coach has a whole straightaway lead, checkered flag to the number eight car, David Payne. Mike Collins will finish in the second place spot, followed by Donald Blanchier and Henderson, John Henderson. Out of South Carolina takes the final transfer spot. So Kerry Jones will have to go home early tonight to the Bristol, Tennessee headquarters of the number six Jones Trucking race car. How about it for the number eight car, race fans? The coach, David Payne. Heat race number one for the limited crates. Let's go, drivers. All right, here we go, race fans. Chip Brindle and Heath Heineman on the front row. BP Brian Pritchard, Brian Burke in row two, Michael Evans, Scott Holmes in row three. Chip Brindle out in front, Heath Heineman in second. Here comes Brian Pritchard. Pritchard to the inside of Heath Heineman. He'll take over second down the back straightaway. Chip Brindle out in front, but here comes BP, Brian Pritchard. White flag is out, Chip Brindle. And Chip Brindle taking the win in the number 38 C car. Brian Pritchard finishing in second, followed by Heath Heineman in the 91. That's your top three on the CarSmart Auto Sales scoreboard in turn three. Johnson in row two, Ricky Williams. He'll run shotgun on the field. Here we go. Eight laps the distance. Winner gets the outside pole for the feature tonight. Jimmy Elliott trying to take over from Brian Kinnersley. Kinnersley slams the door in turn four. Brian Kinnersley now out in front. Jimmy Elliott in second. David Dawes trying to hold off Reed Johnson. Doss trying to take over second from Jimmy J. David Doss, now your second place car. BK, Brian Kinnersley out in front. Yellow flag is out. Caution waving. Brian Kinnersley.
Southern National Series t-shirts. If you want to get you a Southern National Series t-shirt, one for $15, two for $25, right behind the main grandstand area, Big Steve. Don't forget, Late Model Illustrated back on sale back here, Dirt Dud Souvenir Trailer, our official souvenir here at Cleveland Speedway, their souvenir wagon back there, and also the concession stands. Big Steve, up, folks, 4Y24 Ray Cook Southern National Series Late Models around the bull ring here tonight at Cleveland Speedway. Along the main straightaway, fans, they're waving at you. Send them off, Ray Cook Southern National style. Down into quarter number one, the 24 charter members of the Fraternal Order of Go Fast are getting ready to take that deal, win this series championship.
Tell you one thing that I have just learned, Bub McCool in that Victory Circle chassis race car, that is the same chassis that won Saturday night here at the Cleveland Speedway when Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth took victory. All right, race fans, here we go. Keep your eyes in turn three and four. Bub McCool in the 57, Jake Knowles in the 66. Here they come!
Green down the main straightaway. Bob McCool is going to make it turn number one. Bob McCool, here comes Jake Knowles to the outside. And Eddie's going to make it a good two-wide battle down the back straightaway. Knowles to that outside line. Here comes Smokey. Smokey to the inside of Waldo. Side by side, Bob
McCool. Caution in turn one. Three of them stacked, wrapped, and packed. Nice and neatly like a can of sardines. Looks like the 18 car of Jeff Smith involved. Postelli, it looks like Ty Dillon is done. He is in the pit area.
Yep.
They are pushing the car slowly towards the infield, and I believe they are done, finished. Well, he'll get the last place spot.
Yep, and $450 to boot. Crew chief Shane McDowell, veteran crew chief, the brother to Dale McDowell, turning the wrenches for Richard Childress Racing, Team Dillon Racing. We'll try it again. Lights out. Here we go. Bub McCool, Jake Knowles. We'll try it again for a restart. Who's it going to be? McCool and Knowles to the green down the main straightaway. Here we go, racing.
Green flag is out, and off they go into turns one and two. Jake Knowles on the high side. Bub McCool on the inside. Down the back straightaway, side by side into three. Bub McCool is your leader, followed by Jake Knowles in second. Then Cat Daddy Clem Smith, then Chris Madden, followed by Tony Knowles, your top five. Your top two trying to break away. Jake Knowles trying to look to the inside of Bob McCool. Bob McCool, your lap two leader here on the Car Smart Auto Sales scoreboard in turn three. McCool with about a four car length advantage now over Jay Knowles. Here comes Cliff Smith. Cat Daddy rolling to the inside. Can't make it stick. He'll fall back in the line right behind the number 66. Jonathan Davenport into the top five as he gets by Tony Knowles for that fifth place spot. But it is your leader, Bob McCool, setting the pace in that 57J race car. Jay Knowles trying to hold off Cat Daddy Clint Smith. Then back there in fourth, it is the number 44, Chris Smokey Madden. Jonathan Davenport, your top five. Here comes the skipper. Skipper rolls to the inside. He'll take over the sixth place spot. Jay Knowles back to seventh. William Thomas off the pace on the front side. Yellow flag is out for Monty Mara.
The second yellow flag coming out next, Steve, on, I believe, lap six or seven. Will Thomas missed us when we made a trip to his hometown on 69.
All right, race fans, Monty Morrow given the next time by a signal. Bub McCool is in control. Single file restart here for the Southern National Series. It is Jake Knowles, followed by Cat Daddy Clint Smith. Then it is the 44 of Chris Smokey Madden and JD Jonathan Davenport. Green flag is out. Here we go. For the current series points leader, Jonathan Davenport, but still running.
here on lap number 12. Folks, the points are shaking out tonight. Davenport in on the hook is minus up. Good Smith with a restart. Here we go.
Clint Smith is your leader, coming off of turn four, lap number 14, this time by Chris Smokey Madden, followed by Skipper Skip Harp, Randy Weaver in that fourth place spot, battle for fifth. It is the number 18, Eric Wells, looking to the inside of Tony Knoll. Clint Smith off of turn number four, he's being chased by the other 44, Chris Smokey Madden.
Tony Knoll beats a good, respectable fifth place.
Here comes Smokey. Chris Madden looking, trying to reel in that number 44. Battle for the 44 is going at it.
Smokey to the outside. Can he make it stick on the high line? He's trying to chase down Clint Smith. Halfway next time by, folks. Cross flag should be in the air next time by. First Clint Smith.
Here they come, off of turn three and four.
Here comes Smokey. Smokey to the inside, halfway, 18 down. He knows he's there. Clint Smith knows he's there. He's got to hold off the charge. He's the veteran, former Alabama Southern All-Star Series champion as well. He's trying to hold off the charge of Chris Madden to get ready and set the work lap 19.
There are 44s up front. Backmarker traffic about to play into effect. John Henderson's going to go a lap down to the leaders early. Here comes your battle for third. Randy Weaver looking to the inside of the Skipper. Skip Harp, that's third. Back marker traffic for your race leader, Cat Daddy Clint Smith. Single file, he'll pick them off one at a time. Lap 20, this time by lap 21 hit.
15 laps to go. Right now, 14 to go. They come down the car smart. Still up front is the 44, Clint Smith to the inside of Aikens, half still out of John Henderson. He's a lap car. Clint Smith still holds it.
Weaver and Skip Harp going at it. Weaver's got third into turns one and two. Randy the Dream Weaver taking over third. He'll slide up right in front of the Skipper. The coach, David Payne, trying to get to the inside of Tony Knowles for that fifth place spot. He's got it. So David Payne, the coach, takes over fifth from Tony Knoll.
You see the 44 of Chris Madden starts to push. Seems like Clint still towards the bottom side of the racetrack as well as the top. You see the 44 is stretched up. That car has beat his push.
Momentarily clear sailing for Cat Daddy Clint Smith. He's about to put a lap down on Kerry Jones, the number six car out of Bristol, Tennessee. David Payne set his sights on the Skipper, Skip Harp. Payne way down on the bottom. Doing that bottom beating here at the Cleveland Speedway, the coach, David Payne. Car lengths back is Randy the Dream Weaver in third. inside five, this time by two cars right in front of your race leader. Folks, this is gonna get down and dirty. Here comes Madden.
And trying to make a charge, he'll be three to go this time by. Madden down to the bottom side. Here comes Chris Madden. He's trying to make a repeat in the Southern Nationals from last year. Folks, we got a race on our hands. Chris Madden to the inside, side by side down the back straightaway. Race up for the lead as they come down. It'll be two to go. Can't Eddie holds them off down the base straight away. Two more laps to go. Chris Madden's going to lead lap number 33.
Chris Madden by inches. Now Cat Daddy takes the lead in turn two. Down the back straightaway. This should be the white flag lap. Here they come off of turn four, Chris Tilly. White flag is in the air for Cat Daddy Clint Smith. He's got two slower cars in front of him. The last time, here they come. Cat Daddy and Chris Madden off of turn four. Clint Smith will take the checkered flag.
Oh, man. It was an exciting show.
So,
him in victory lane was in St. Clairsville, Ohio. He's back for his second career Southern National Series win. Tell us about that run to the checkers.
Oh, I tell you, my guys were telling me where Chris was, and I moved up. Then he got a big run on me, about two to go on the bottom. And then the white flag lap is beside me, coming down for the white flag, and I just went about five more car lengths farther than I've been all night. And it stuck, and we got back around him, but he's a heck of a racer and a good competitor, and just glad to get a win here in one of my favorite racetracks, Cleveland, Tennessee, and glad to be back.
You took the lead on lap number 13, led to lap number 32. He officially led lap 33. When did you know you had to make the move and hold off the position for the win?
When I seen him hurt his motor under me, and I knew we had to go then. I knew Bub McCool was strong early, and he was on softer rubber. Don't know if we had anything for him or not, but I don't know what happened to him. It's tough luck for Bub. I thought he was going to get him two in a row, but we'll take him any way we can get him this day and age.
Sixth in the points heading into tonight with Southern Nationals, your regular, the World of Outlaws. Two events left. Are you going to make the haul? This is going to shake up the points with Davenport and Knowles. You need to try to be there the next two nights.
Yeah, we're going to finish out the tour. We didn't get in the top six here. I'm sorry I missed the first race. We just couldn't get ready off that North Dakota road trip we come on. I barely made it to Gaffney. So we're on the next road trip already. We're headed from here on out to the Ohio Speed Weeks from Tazewell. We're not even coming back home. We're already on the road. So we got to do the best we can do. This is a good way to start it off.
Cat Daddy, I know you got to thank your great sponsors. I'll let you do that real quick.
JP Drilling's one main man, and Fiber and Tank Lines, Base Fuel, Race Tech, Race Engines. We put a brand new gun in today. It paid off. Last night we had a little bit of trouble, and we put a new one in today, big 445, and we used it all that last lap trying to get back in the lead. So Rocket Chassis, first win with a Rocket here, and just glad everybody's on board with me. Got a my crew chief, Darrell, and Brian, we've both been working for 2 weeks now, just nonstop, every day and night, and we rolled in about 7:45 today, so as quick as we could get here, but we all glad to be in victory circle, and now we just got to get a, we don't want to fall off a win, but we need a second tomorrow night, or at least, to make a first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth on this tour, so just glad to be back, and glad to see everybody, and maybe see you at the end of the year at the Gobbler.
All right, he's had top five finishes every night this season.
44, Reed Johnson, Michael Evans, Ricky Lewis, and Scott Olms round out the field. Final race of the night right here, race fans, 20 laps the distance. Brendel and Kennersley bringing them to green. Chip Brendel, Brian Pritchard in third, then Jimmy Elliott and David Doss. Brendel not giving up. He's on the inside of the 27K, Brian Kinnersley. out of the race as Brian Kinnersley still leads Chip Brindle, followed by Brian Pritchard. Off the racetrack, he's in the infield. Brian Kinnersley putting Ricky Lewis a lap down. Race leader Brian Kinnersley looking at five to go, this time by. Chip Brindle about a five car lengths back. Goes around in turn one, bringing out the yellow flag. Brian Pritchard trying to lap your 14 car. Back to green here at the Cleveland Speedway, and Brian Kinnersley, your leader. Down the back straightaway in turn three and four for the final time. Brian Kinnersley taking the win. Chip Brindle finishing in second. Brian Pritchard third. Jimmy Elliott fourth. Reed Johnson barely getting by David Doss for that fifth place spot. That is going to do it for us here tonight, folks. Thank you for coming out tonight. Please drive home safely. We'll see you back here real soon. Saturday night we are racing. B Hobby Mid-Season Championship plus Super Late Models, Limited Crates, A Hobbies, and Ponies. Reminder, no more front-wheel drives here at the Cleveland Speedway. And again, for Monty Morrow and the entire staff and family here at the Cleveland Speedway, I'm Big Steve. Thanks for coming out for Chris Tilley and Ray Cook. We'll see you back here real soon. Follow them to the Southern Nationals on Friday, tomorrow night at the Volunteer Speedway in Bulls Gap, Tennessee. Again, folks, thanks for coming out. Drive home safely. Good night, and God bless.